Then in 2014, a group of psychologists working with Facebook announced that they had found a way to put hidden messages into people's news feeds that would then create specific moods and feelings without the individuals being aware of it. It was the moment when the psychologists' theories of priming, or nudging, fused with the power of the new technology. And it seemed to show that manipulation could work on an industrial scale. But when it was revealed, it also had another unintended effect. It began to sow a dark suspicion into people's minds, because they no longer knew whether what they were feeling or thinking was their own, or really coming from outside sources. But for the machines, that was no problem, because suspicion was also another perfect high arousal emotion that they could feed off. And suspicion was about to spread uncontrollably across the internet. Because into this mix came two terrible shocks. The first was Brexit, the other was the election of Donald Trump. The shock of both these was enormous, especially for the liberal classes, who had always seen themselves as protecting the working class. They protested, but the shock was so intense that many people found it difficult to process what had happened. They couldn't imagine why the people had not only turned against them and their benign care, but also seemed to have voted against their own best interests. And to explain it, they latched on to the idea of hidden manipulation, that thousands of voters in America and in Britain had been manipulated online without them realizing it. But then things became more complicated, because evidence had started to come out from the world of science that questioned the whole idea that people could be manipulated in such a way. Psychology researchers had tried to repeat a number of the most important experiments that were the foundations of modern behavioral psychology. They were astonished to find that again and again, when they repeated the experiments, they failed to get the original results. It seemed that much of the evidence for priming just wasn't there. It got so bad that one of the most famous psychologists in the world, who had promoted the idea of priming, Daniel Kahneman, wrote an open email to the Science of Psychology. "I see a train wreck looming," he said. "We have become the poster child for doubts about the integrity of psychological research." Kahneman was frightened because it was undermining the idea that he had helped create, that in the human brain were systems that the conscious self was unaware of, but which you, the psychologist, could trigger unconsciously. But it also had wider implications, because it meant that companies like Cambridge Analytica, who claimed that they could alter the way people behaved by priming, might just be exploiting the hysteria and the suspicion. The truth was that you might be able to keep millions of people in a state of constant anxiety online by bombarding them with memes, but you couldn't alter underneath what they thought and what they believed. People might be far stronger than the scientists believed. But it was too late, because once you believe you are being manipulated, there is no way back. Even being told you are not being manipulated might be manipulation. The liberal opposition became lost in an endless conspiracy theory, constantly searching for hidden clues, links, and fragments of evidence to prove that really Vladimir Putin and firms like Cambridge Analytica had orchestrated Brexit and the election of Donald Trump. It was a mood of hysteria that ran out of control.
whether the President of the United States was a Russian agent. Let me say that again. Whether the US President might have been working for the Russians.
The walls closing in.
As it appears, the walls are closing in terms of the Mueller investigation.
The walls are closing in.
The walls are closing in.
I do feel that he feels the walls closing in on him.
Legal walls are closing in on Donald Trump tonight.
From a Democratic perspective, this is the president who feels like the walls are closing in.
As he feels the walls are closing in.
I think he's feeling the Russian investigation. I think he's feeling the walls closing in on him.
But what had really been manufactured by the hysteria and the suspicion was a constant source of those high arousal emotions that the machines needed. They didn't care about the meaning of what people thought or felt about Donald Trump. They just fed off the waves of paranoia, making the technology companies ever more profitable and powerful. But many of those old institutions who had been sidelined also found that by promoting the suspicions, they could regain their power.
Trump is about to call me.
Can't trust what they tell us.
Major newspapers in America and in Britain that might have gone bankrupt without Donald Trump were rescued by the continual waves of conspiracy theories they revealed. While the intelligence agencies, who only a few years before had been hated because they had invented the weapons of mass destruction, now became heroic truth-tellers, revealing ever more hidden conspiracies. And Vladimir Putin, whose power in reality was becoming increasingly fragile at home in Russia, became in the eyes of the West a dark, malevolent force, which made him seem far stronger than he really was.
Так, друзья, обрадуем жителей данного подъезда, повесим Владимира Владимировича прямо в лифт. Так, ровненько, ровненько, ровненько. Отлично, кажется.
Твою мать!
О, ну что это?
Ё-моё!
What the f***? Ой, ёб твою мать!
And for Donald Trump, the paranoia allowed him to hide the fact that he was doing nothing to get rid of the corruption in America, as he had promised. His supporters, though, had their own conspiracy theory, QAnon, that explained why nothing was happening. Trump was being stopped by a secret cabal of paedophiles in Washington. And for the liberal opposition, it was a way of avoiding facing up to the genuine grievances and the very real anger in America that Trump's election had revealed. That he might be the product of a country where large areas had fallen into both desolation and despair. Towns where all the factories had closed. Millions had become addicted to opioids. And yet no one in power had come to rescue them. But the liberals couldn't face this, because they too had no idea of how to solve those problems. And outside, in the real world, nothing actually changed. The structure of power, the inequalities, and the decay all carried on unchecked. While all kinds of groups who wanted to cling on to power protected themselves behind this brittle shell of conspiracy theories, built out of disconnected fragments. But it was a very fragile structure.